Hi, I'm Preston Williams, and welcome to Jazz Talk. I'm here in downtown Baltimore at Keystone Corner, one of the hot spots for jazz, and I'm sitting here with one of the world's greatest drummers. I'm talking about Cindy Blackman Santana. Cindy, welcome to Jazz Talk.
Thank you so much.
You know, I just caught your set. You guys were on fire. It was fantastic. And I'm just curious, you were here a couple of months ago. You guys did a couple of sets, and I was just curious, why did you come back to Keystone Corner? What is it about this place that made you want to come back and record?
Oh, I love it here. I love the vibration here. First of all, Todd, you know, the owner here, Todd Barkin, he's just a walking historian because he's been around so much music. He's been involved with, you know, allowing so much music to happen through having an amazing club. And so he's a joy to be around. So I love Todd. He's really good. And we're good friends, you know. But this club is really special, too, because the people who come really listen to the music. They're really intently listening. And when you're going on a journey, no matter where you're going, they're right there with you. So for us, it's a beautiful thing because it helps us feel free enough to just explore as we want to. You know, we don't feel like we're in a box.
Beautiful,
you know.
Beautiful. You know, let's talk about this band that you've assembled together, Aurelian Buddyneck, Mark Carey, and Felix Pastoris. How did you go about putting this band together? What do they bring to this group that you currently have?
You know, all these cats are really, first and foremost, they're all great musicians, you know, but aside from that, and you know, you want to play with the best people that you can find so that not only are you pushing them, but they are pushing you as well, you know, because you want inspiration. But they're all incredible listeners, you know, and so with big ears like that, the music has a chance to grow, and they all love to explore, and they all have a history about them in terms of the music that they've studied, the music that they love, you know, all the things that they incorporate, which gives the band a bigger vocabulary, you know. So all of these cats are here because of those reasons, you know.
You know, Cindy, over the years, you've played with so many great artists, from Joe Henderson to Sam Rivers, Carlos Santana, of course, and so many, Lenny Kravitz. Now, you are one of the few drummers that I've seen that plays in different genres as far as rock music and jazz, and I guess you that's part of your, you know, your repertoire, but has that influenced you in some way as far as being a leader of a band, playing with all these different musicians over the years? Has that sort of helped you or shaped you as a leader, you know, as far as like leading a group in the direction in which you want to go musically?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, it's helped me because I had a chance to really watch how people led groups, you know, what they did that I wouldn't choose to do, what they did that I would choose to do, you know, so I could weed out and take the things that suited my personality and my direction, you know. And then watching bands, you know, like I would go see different bands, and especially I love watching drummer leaders, you know, so watching Elvin lead his bands and Art Blakey and Jimmy Cobb and Roy and Philly and Tony and all the great drummers, you know, I got to see them lead their bands and see how they did it, you know. Pete LaRocca, all these drummers from New York, and so many more, you know, Al Foster, Billy Hart. I saw these cats, you know, playing. Lenny White, I saw him lead his bands. You know, all these cats I got to see, you know, with other bands as sidemen, and then I got to see them lead bands. So that was also great. So just watching different leaders, you know, especially on drums, but, you know, every instrument, you know, and then and that's just from an audience perspective. So, you know, as a lover of music and a spectator, but then being in bands, as I said, you know, I got to see how people did things, you know, what they chose to do, why, what they didn't choose to do, and I could weed out and say, well, I would do that differently, you know, I would do this, I would do that, I wouldn't do this, I wouldn't do that, you know.
Now, there's a special individual that I wanted to talk about who's had a major influence on you. I know you just mentioned some of your favorite drummers like Art Blakey, Max Roach, Lenny White, but there's one guy that we all still talk about today. His name is Tony Williams. He had a tremendous influence on you. Talk about Tony and how he influenced you, and it's just all-encompassing how he's affected so many drummers today. Talk about Tony.
Nobody has influenced me as much as Tony. I mean, Tony is my ultimate hero. I love Tony because, you know, he innovated on every single front, you know. And first of all, you have to love what you're hearing. So his sound, he was a sound innovator. Mm-hmm. The tone of his drums was so beautiful. Mm-hmm. The cymbals that he chose sounded like a beautiful symphony, you know. So, you know, if you hear somebody who's got a great tone, like you hear Miles, you want to hear more notes, but you could be satisfied by hearing one note. It sounds so beautiful, you know. So Tony was a sound innovator, you know, and that is a huge influence on me because I love, I'm an audiophile, you know, I love great audio and great sounds. So that is very inspiring to me. He's a conceptual genius, you know, his concept was just crazy incredible. And, you know, he changed the face of music so many times, and he changed the whole palette for drummers, you know, and the whole vocabulary that we have and the choices that we have. He just opened it up so much. Technically, he's like beyond compare. There's nobody who has his kind of technique. And you would hear him do something, and when he does it, sometimes it sounds easy, but when you try, you say, oh, that's not easy. It just sounded easy because he's so fluid and you know, and he does it so flawlessly, you know. So his vocabulary was just incredible, you know. So all the innovations that he did were just astounding to me. So Tony, and I can, you know, talk specifically about his innovations, but Tony just overall, you know, and as well with all the musics that he incorporated in what he was doing, he was very open. Mm. You know, he wasn't an in the box kind of guy. You know, an in box kind of player. You know, he is a leader. You know, a leader in our music, a leader of the drums. You know, and he loved the drums. He loved playing the music, and you know, he had a you could see it, you could hear it, you can feel it. He had a passion for the drums. You know, passion for playing music, and you know, and I have that.
Yes.
And you know, part of me having that was influenced by him as well. You know, I saw him very early on doing a drum clinic, and it was so intense and so passionate and so incredible in every way, technically, conceptually. Just his musicality was amazing, and I said, that is the path. If I'm not chasing that, I might as well be reading a book or doing something else, because I'm not doing it right.
Well, you know, one of his last recordings, which gosh, influenced me, was Wilderness. You could see him developing as a composer. You know, we were just talking about him the other day. It's been, I guess, 23 years ago since he passed away, but I think drummers like yourself would do him proud how you've taken his stuff and just taken it to a new level. And it's just a pleasure to sit here and talk with you today, Cindy. And we're down here at Keystone Corner. If you haven't had the opportunity to see Cindy's set, please come out tomorrow. She will be here tomorrow performing two sets. And as the same goes, if the music grooves and makes you move, it must be jazz. I'm Preston Williams with Jazz Talk, signing off. Peace.